Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let me show you how you can slow down a portion of a track in GarageBand. So here's something I get asked about every once in a while. How do you slow down some audio using GarageBand? But not just slow down the audio in its entirety, but only a section of it. Like if you want a song to slow down at the end, or at least a track from a song. So I'm going to go into GarageBand and I'm going to create an empty project. But I want to point out I've got this audio file right here. And this audio file is just a looping guitar piece. And it loops at the same speed. And I want it to slow down at the end. So I'm going to drag that into the project. Let's create the empty project here. And then I'm going to drag and drop this file in. So there I go. I'm going to position it all the way to the left. And now I've got this guitar bit right here. And if I play it, you can hear the loop. All right, so that just loops over and over again. But what I want to do is here at the end, right about here, I want it to slow down to the end there. So in order to do that, I need to enable some things. So let's clean this up first. I've got this blank track here. I'm going to select it and then use Command Delete to get rid of it. So now I just have that recorded guitar track there. Now I'm going to go to Track and Show Tempo Track. And I think this is exactly what we want, the tempo track. We can drag this line down and slow things down. But that's not what the tempo track does, at least not right now. Because what it will actually do is it will tell GarageBand that the tempo of this is something different. Right now, it doesn't know. It's just recorded audio. So we've told it, it's 120 beats per second or per minute. Well, if we were to change it to 90, it would say, great, I'm still playing at the same speed, but you've just told me that that speed is 90 beats per minute. So it's not going to affect this track. It'll just affect other things we bring in, like other loops and things like that. So we'll see no change if we adjust tempo, at least not yet. Now we want to go to View, Show Editor. And here we've got the editor here at the bottom. If you can't see the follow tempo and pitch here, down here at the bottom, first make sure you're set to region, not track. So click on region. And then you could drag this line here up to make sure you see everything here at the bottom. Another thing you want to make sure is make sure you have this selected up here. See how I can have it not selected and then selected. It's got to be selected or you won't be able to check off follow tempo and pitch, which is what we want. Now even with this selected sometimes, this won't check off. Sometimes I find you have to do something like turn on flex and then off flex and then it will check it off. I don't know why you need to do that sometimes, not others, but you can see everything's the same. I've just turned that on and off. The bottom line is you need to get this checked either by checking it or turning this on and off here. And now that we have follow tempo and pitch turned on, we can slow down this track for real. Now I could just drag this line down here and it would slow things down. And you can hear it slower. But we don't want to slow down the entire thing. So I'll go back to 120 beats per minute and I'm going to use the Command key on my keyboard and click on the line right here. You can see when I hold the Command key down, I get this little pen or knife here. I'm not sure what that icon's supposed to be. But I can click right there and I create a dot. And now I can adjust this line here. So I can have a sudden abrupt change in speed right at this point. I don't want an abrupt change in speed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back up here to 120 and I'm going to put another point right here at the end. And then I'm going to, you can see this is a line here I can drag. I actually have 3 points now. When I've created that other one, I've got this point, that point, and this middle point that was created. I can drag this down to where I want it. So let's drag this way down and I can go down below the bottom of that. Notice the number there next to change tempo. 60, 50, 40. I'll go down to 40 to really slow. And then this will jump and change so that it adjusts there. And I've got this middle thing here. I can click that and now I can put a curve. So obviously this will slow it down at an even pace. And this will do it at a curved pace. So slow it down a little bit first and then suddenly it drops off quickly. Or I can have it drop off quickly and then the rate of slowing down will change. So I'm just going to go and do the middle thing right there. And now when I'll set the playhead here and you can hear it slow down. So there you go. I've successfully been able to slow this down, just this section of it here. Now, if I want to actually use this in a song, what I want to do at this point, since this tempo track is actually changing everything that's going on in the song here, I'm going to want to export it. I'm going to go share, export song to disk, and export this out as Guitar 2. And then I'll bring this Guitar 2 into the GarageBand composition that has many tracks and all sorts of different things in it, knowing that I've got this slow down part here. I could even, if I wanted to, have just slowed down just a portion of it and use this as a segment to put into the song. I don't have to have the entire guitar track in here, of course. Now, if your intention is to actually have this fade out as well as slow down, then you can click on the Show Hide Automation button here, and now I get a line inside the track, and I can command click on that, and it works in a very similar way, but the difference being that this is volume, not speed. So now not only will it slow down, but it will fade out.